You came just in time. I made way too many nachos for just me. But actually, I need all these nachos because I need the energy to go to the beach later today. And because they're delicious. By the end of today's lesson, you'll be able to describe what energy is and identify examples of energy in the real world. You'll also be able to explain the relationship between energy and forces and motion. Let's get into it! Energy is everywhere. It's what keeps our bodies, our world, and our whole universe running. In our lesson on matter, we learned that everything in the universe is either matter or energy. But what is energy exactly? Well, in science, energy is simply the ability to do work. If you recall from our study of simple machines, work is the application of force on an object to cause motion. So, energy is what allows us to exert force and cause motion, or in other words, to do work. Energy exists in many different forms. The light and heat we feel from the sun is energy. The electricity powering the device that you're using to watch this video is energy. Even the food we eat has stored energy in it. The calories on a nutrition label will actually tell you what the amount of energy is in that food. Even though all these things are very different, they are all forms of energy. So, energy is everywhere. Let's see if we can identify some of the different places we use energy as I head out to the beach. As my body breaks down those delicious nachos, their stored energy is released. I can then use that energy to walk down to the beach. Oh wow, the weather is perfect today. The sun's energy is providing us with the light to see, and the heat energy is gonna make that water feel amazing. Let's pick up the pace. Ooh, we made it to the beach. Hey, do you hear that? I think someone's playing music. Electrical energy is powering someone's speakers, and then the speaker is releasing sound energy that travels through the air into my ears. Good thing I still have some energy from those nachos to bust out these forces and motions. Woo! I'm getting tired. My body needs a lot of energy to dance, keep itself cool, and digest those nachos from earlier. Maybe I should replenish my body's energy in the form of some ice cream. So while I eat this, take a look around you. What other examples of energy can you find? Pause the video here and jot down your thoughts in your guided notes. That ice cream was tasty. Oh, sorry, I didn't leave any for you, but that got me thinking. What happens to energy after we use it? My body will use the energy from the ice cream to go swimming, but then what? Does the energy just disappear? It clearly takes a lot of energy to keep the universe running. Luckily for us, we can't actually run out of it. An important property of our universe is the law of conservation of energy, which tells us that energy can neither be created nor destroyed. When energy is used, it's changed into a different form of energy. For example, the light energy from the sun doesn't just disappear once it reaches the Earth. Plants transform that energy and store it as food through the process of photosynthesis, which they can use to grow and make seeds. The electrical energy used to turn on a light bulb is converted into light and heat. And the mechanical energy I use to apply force to this beach ball is then converted into the beach ball's motion. Score! Goal? I don't really do sports. Can you think of any other examples of energy changing forms? Pause the video here to jot down your thoughts in your guided notes. So, energy is always conserved or saved. We can't create new energy, we have to get it from somewhere else, and the energy we use is never destroyed, it just changes into different forms. Which is great news for me because I want to keep this beach day going! While I soak up some more rays, let's review everything we've learned today. Energy is the ability to do work. It exists in many different forms, such as heat and electricity. Energy can neither be created nor destroyed, only changed from one form to another. This is called the law of conservation of energy. To learn more about energy, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions for this lesson. Ooh. Maybe I spent a little too much time absorbing the sun's energy. Next time, I will try to remember to reapply my sunscreen more often. Until then, remember everyone, science is all around us. See you next, oh. Hey.